Hi, I'm Veronica Vance. Coming up, we visit a Civil War reenactment at Wolcott Mill Metro Park. Head to the heart of downtown for some tasty Italian at Angelina's. And then we see how the D celebrates the end of summer and kicks off fall. So stay tuned.
Production funding for this program was made possible by the Detroit Metro Convention and Visitors Bureau, driving tourism growth in Metro Detroit since 1896. More information is available at visitdetroit.com.
Metro Detroit has 13 metro parks, but two of them are in Macomb County. We've got Stony Creek Metro Park, which has tons of great trails for biking, hiking, beautiful trees for the fall colors. Then we've got Wolcott Mill Metro Park, which is in Ray Township. That's comprised of two areas. We've got the Farm Center, where in the fall you can go out on a hayride, pick pumpkins. They've got a real-life working farm there. And then we've got the Grist Historic Mill, where they have lots of activities going on throughout the fall and throughout every weekend, actually. But we're here this weekend for a Civil War reenactment. It happens every year in the fall, and it's a great time to be had. So let's go check it out.
It's a great time and one of our biggest events. And we usually have about 400 or 500 reenactors come out here. And people do enjoy it. A lot of great things going on all the time here. People get to see some demonstrations of the musket firing, cannon firing. We have a lot of crafts that are going on. They demonstrate things that would have been done at that time of the year.
Well, Bill, this looks like an adventurous place, and I'm going to go take a look around.
Okay, well, I hope you come back again, because we have a lot of things going on here, and we're the best kept secret in the metro parks.
So Dave, you're kind of in charge of this whole event here, and we are standing out here in the middle of the park. What camp are we in?
We have now entered the federal camp. This weekend, the Federals are reenacting the 4th Michigan Infantry Regiment. What we're doing is we're portraying the 4th Michigan and their actions in and around Shepherdstown, West Virginia. Mm-hmm. Basically what you're seeing here, and if you look over in the camp, the individuals who are reenacting this have actually reproduced the original uniforms that the 4th Michigan Infantry wore would have been in September of 1862.
This is actually what they wore?
Yes.
Can you tell me a little bit about your uniform then?
My sack coat is a standard federal issue. Mm-hmm. Sack coat, blue wool, it is lined. Some are not. They're not as hot as people think they are. Trousers, also a standard federal issue. Early in the war, the 4th Michigan wore dark trousers. The hat is unique. It's called a Canada hat. Many of the men wearing this style of hat.
I'd like to show you the regimentals of the 4th Michigan Infantry. Now the 4th Michigan Reenactment Group purchased an original blank that was left over from the Civil War, and they actually hand-painted what the words and the pictures were on the original flag.
Touching a piece of history.
Oh yeah. Yes, it's unbelievable. The interesting thing about today was we literally had crowds following us as we moved in and out of the different battlefield scenarios that we were participating in today.
So visitors get to get up close and personal even during the battles and
absolutely.
The fighting?
They're always welcome in the camps. They're always welcome in the civilian areas. Anyone here is more than happy to explain their portion of the history that we're portraying here this weekend.
So what are we standing in here? This is...
This would be an exact replica of a Civil War field hospital. This particular one is a Confederate hospital, and it's here in support of the sponsoring company here, which is the 4th Texas Infantry.
Okay.
All of the equipment that you see around here is authentic, or it's an authentic reproduction of the tools the physicians would have used during the war.
Well, so now Dave, we're in the area called Sisters of the Union. So what does this mean? What was their role?
The Sisters of the Union, what this group of reenactors does is they authentically cook, authentically sew, they dye yarn. You'll notice that there's an authentic bathhouse here. And they do is they teach the history of what life was like in the 19th century and the different skills that they had. One of the nice things about coming out here is you can go to a museum and look at different things, mm-hmm. but when you come out here, you actually get to see how it was done with people that are doing it.
You need to get back to camp, and yes. We are in the civilian area, and you're
absolutely.
Gonna...
And I'm gonna turn you over to a good friend of mine, John. They're all yours.
Well, as Dave said, we're in the civilian area. So what exactly does that mean?
Well, this would be representative of the civilian refugees from the war and during the Civil War. Mm-hmm. They would a lot of times follow the camps and travel with them. They'd acquire military tents and they'll set up the different camps, showing what civilian life on the road as a refugee would represent. Mm-hmm. Everybody loves to ask, is that a real fire? Yes, it's a real fire. Are you really cooking there? Yes. And yes, they really sleep in the tents.
Now what
they're playing
is
the game Graces.
It's called
Graces.
It's a children's game. Mm-hmm. And the one child with the hoop is going to take their sticks and propel it to the other. And I'm going to have you just stand just a little out on the bench.
And you need
okay.
to catch it.
So I need to catch it with my sticks. Oh, not bad. Okay.
What another example of some of the period games that the kids can come out when they visit the park and they visit the reenactment that they're playing. It's kind of like a similar Jenga game there. You stack the bricks and you have some more Graces rings there.
The characters say come on and become part of it. And
yes,
you're learning and you don't even realize that
exactly.
You're learning history.
Good point. Well, here's another good example of the kids when they come out to play. They can build their own forts and they can hold off the enemy troops as long as they're able.
Have fun.
And then we have a good example here of our cavalry camp where troops from throughout the state of Michigan will come and they'll bring their horses. Mm-hmm. And a lot of kids love to see the horses too. It's a lot of fun.
Well, John, thank you so much for showing me the civilian life.
Well, I appreciate you coming by. Hope you guys had a good time. Make sure you get back out and walk around and see as much as you can.
Oh, I'm so excited.
As we did in the 1860s. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, the Civil War reenactment gives you an idea of what life was like in the 1860s, and the Metro Parks give you an opportunity to get out and explore nature. You know those cozy Italian restaurants that you see in the movies? You know the kind with a great location, the fabulous city views, and the warm, welcoming atmosphere? Well, we have one of those Italian restaurants right here in downtown Detroit, Angelina Italian Bistro. We're in the old Madison Theater.
The old Madison Theater, and it's right on the corner of Broadway and Grand Circus Park. right across the street from the Detroit Opera House, Comerica Park, down the street from the Fox, and we're right on the People Mover. So anywhere that the People Mover goes, people can get to us or come here for dinner and go there. So it's
just easy access, yes, right in the heart, absolutely, of it all. And you guys have just had rave reviews of your food as well.
It's nice to hear not just the reviews from the press, but when people come in and say, I've had a fantastic time, I'm taking a stack of cards, I'm emailing all my friends. It's really nice.
You've also mentioned you've got a lot of local Detroit touches in here. Can,
absolutely,
we go kind of take,
absolutely,
a peek at some of those?
We wanted people to remember what the building was, and that was the Madison Theater. That's a painting from a 1928 photo.
Oh, it's a painting. It actually looks like an actual photograph.
Yeah.
So this, again, is the Antipasta Bar?
Yeah, we call it the Antipasta Bar. I mean, we wanted an open kitchen. If you wanted to, you could be on the, really, on the firing line here. We make all our pasta from scratch, our pizza from scratch. We smoke our own fish, cure our own meats. We do have people that come in, I want to sit at the Antipasta Bar. I want to see what's going on in the kitchen.
So you've got a very nice, spacious dining room here.
Yes, we seat about 100 people. The bar, in addition, seats about 30.
Okay.
And then we have a little private dining room that we can get about 15 people in.
Well, Tom, on the note of talking about the food, it's really got my mouth watering to try some of it.
Excellent. Well, let's try some.
Wow. This is beautiful. I mean, presentation is such a part of eating, and
absolutely,
this is just phenomenal.
Over here is our eggplant torre, and basically we've taken polenta. We also have a goat cheese that's layered with eggplant, and then a grilled portobello mushroom. We finish it with the bitter arugula greens and a little bit of balsamic reduction. Next here, this is our stucolo. It's a chicken and Sicilian caponata stucolo. And basically, you take zucchini squash, eggplant, olive oil, a little bit of onions, capers, olives. We've incorporated that into with chicken, into the phyllo pastry dough. And then a little side of our sauteed vegetables, yellow and green squash. This is one of our signature dishes. It's called the La Angelina. This is an artisan salami,
okay,
mortadella. This one has pistachios. That is a mousse made with bay scallops. This is a smoked salmon. And then we have the different roasted vegetables here. This is the brusolo, Tony Soprano's favorite.
Yeah.
Grilled fennel, grilled asparagus, and grilled green onions here. And of course, olives to go with that. These are handmade ravioli.
Mm.
And they're stuffed with ricotta cheese, and we put thyme, oregano, and basil. We do a white wine butter sauce with the roasted garlic and the tomatoes, and then the artichoke hearts. And then this is only one of our desserts, dark chocolate, white chocolate, milk chocolate, dark chocolate crumbles on the top, and finished with chocolate in the mint leaf, and it's absolutely amazing. We also make a traditional tiramisu. She makes apple tarts and cakes, cookies, all sorts of things.
Wow. So,
fennel has anise flavor to it, and a lot of Italians cook with it.
Yeah, and the salmon smoked right on the premises. Brizzolo. Tony Soprano would be happy, right?
Oh. Scallop mousse, this is so beautiful.
Mmm,
that's nice.
Yeah. I'm so excited to try this.
The polenta, which again is my favorite here. But the polenta, like I said, I've had polenta before, and Chef Joel's polenta is just...
That is phenomenal. That is so good. It's so light. Mm, that balsamic taste on it, that's delicious. Mm-hmm. Oh, the asparagus is phenomenal. That's better than my grilled asparagus. I think I make pretty good grilled asparagus. That's good. Caponata. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Ooh, I like the red pepper flavor. That's very good. Mm. I don't know what I would order when I came back. I'd have to see if you set me up again.
I'll let you try some of the ravioli.
Now this is all homemade, all your pasta's homemade.
Oh yes. And it's really a struggle sometimes to keep up. And he's sometimes in here 12 hours a day making pasta. So.
The sauce on that is so yummy.
The again,
butter wine, you said?
Yeah,
butter
white wine. White wine, butter. And this will change.
We need taste TV. This is delicious.
Hopefully that's not too big for you.
That's like a little piece of heaven. And so light. They could easily eat that whole thing because it's not that heavy. Tom, thank you so much for a fabulous meal.
You're very welcome. My pleasure.
And if you are looking for scrumptious Italian food beautifully prepared, then look no further than Angelina Italian Bistro, right in the heart of downtown. Great views, and this says it all right here. There are plenty of things to see and do in Metro Detroit this month, and our calendar of events is up next to point you in the right direction. Head to Shane Park for the entertaining Universe Soul Circus and take a time travel adventure at the Michigan Renaissance Festival. Find a deal on that perfect boat at the InWater Metro Boat Show. And Northville's Victorian Festival is now the Heritage Festival. Explore historic Detroit sites on two wheels, then revisit out-of-production cars at the Orphan Car Show. Enjoy citywide creativity during the Detroit Design Festival. Then pick up something eccentric at the funky Ferndale Art Fair. Shop for shabby chic, industrial, farmhouse, and vintage in Holly. Then dress the decades for the Ovation Yacht's last summer cruise. Journey along with the princesses as they dare to dream. Then have adult fun at the inaugural Bootlegger Heritage Festival. Don't miss A Gentleman's Guide to Love and Murder at the Fisher or the stand-up comedy of Amy Schumer at the Joe. To learn of any changes, log on to visitdetroit.com or call 1-800-DETROIT. Labor Day weekend is one of the biggest weekends in the D, and it's a ton of fun for locals, but it also makes a great weekend getaway if you're coming in from out of town. We've got Ford, Arts, Beats, and Eats, the Detroit Jazz Festival, the Michigan State Fair. It's the unofficial end of summer and a great kickoff for the fall. So here at Ford Arts Beats and Eats, they take over the hip town of Royal Oak with over 200 performances on 9 different stages. We've got a smorgasbord of food, a juried art fair, a carnival, and a portion of the small entrance fee goes toward local charities. What more could you ask for Labor Day weekend? So the art part of Arts Beats and Eats is a juried art show. They've got blocks and blocks of one-of-a-kind unique pieces. Like in here, we've got some really neat stuff. Look at these clocks. This one is a guitar. I love that. And we got the beats. Of course, the Eats part of Ford Arts Beats and Eats is huge. I've got all kinds of food here. Right here, we're in front of the Peking House. We've got some delicious looking, what is it?
Chicken.
Okay, and then
vegetable lo mein.
And
we'll have the barbecue spare ribs and vegetable spring rolls.
Smells spectacular. Looks good.
Thank you.
I love cannoli, so thank you. What do we got here?
So this is almond, pecan, and chocolate chip cannolis.
Pecan cannolis?
Yes.
Oh, that one's mine. A little bite of heaven there. Love the pecans on
them. Thank you.
They've also got shopping. They've got these really cool, unique purses, handbags. They've got some big tote bags, all kinds of really neat clothing that you can only find at festivals. And they also have a kid zone full of bouncy houses, and there's kiddie rides back over there just for the little ones, kind of separated from the big rides. It's a nice layout here. They've got crafts over there, a kiddie stage, all kinds of fun stuff for the little ones. There's even more than Arts, Beats, and Eats in downtown Royal Oak. They have this huge midway here. Tons of rides for the kids, a lot of fun.
I've been coming here just every single year, just enjoying myself, because it's pretty much the end of summer. So you might as well just go out with a big old bang and just have fun.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
Well, what a better way.
what a better way
to enjoy Michigan.
Well, John, this Ford Arts Meets and Eats, it's massive. It's huge.
Yes, it is.
Great.
It is amazing. 18 blocks of entertainment. You know, you turn a corner and you hear a different sound. You smell something different. You see something different in the art fair. It really is a festival of the senses. And, you know, I will tell you, the most rewarding part is the amount of people we've brought together in peace. We've struck a nice chord for Metro Detroit. Labor Day weekend has been something regionally that has set Detroit apart. Yes. You know, you have the Jazz Fest, the State Fair, the festival in Hamtramck. You have the Renaissance Festival. There are so many amazing events, and I think Metro Detroit has set itself up as the number one, you know, end of summer celebration capital in the United States by miles and miles. Just fabulous things. If people stay at home, they really do get a vacation of
a
many different genres. A staycation, exactly.
And now, what else is going on right this second in downtown Detroit is the Detroit Jazz Festival, and it's the largest free of charge jazz festival in the world. The Jazz Festival is huge, and it takes over several city blocks, all the way from Hart Plaza to Campus Martius. They've got 5 stages and 100 acts over 4 days. And don't forget, it's all free. Now the other biggie that's happening right this very minute is the Michigan State Fair, and that takes place out of the Suburban Collection Showplace in Novi.
We have kiddie rides, adult rides, spectacular rides, something for the whole family to do today.
Yeah, I mean, all the way down from your little toddlers up to your teenagers, everybody's got something they're going to want to ride. Well, pretty exciting. We've got Tigers going through flaming hoops behind us.
This is a full-fledged circus. We have everything. Lions, tigers, and elephants.
Oh, my!
We've got over 490 livestock here, everything from our draft horses with Clydesdales. We've got over 120 head of sheep. We've got hogs. We've got goats. We've got dairy cattle here, even poultry and rabbits. So we've really got everything you can think about for those city folks or even us country guys. And we have some excellent animals that represent the whole state of Michigan here.
So we've got the three biggies going on this weekend: Arts Beats and Eats, the Jazz Festival, and the State Fair. And if you want to make a weekend getaway out of it, whether you're a local or you're coming in from out of town, there are plenty of places to stay. Like for the State Fair out of the Suburban Collection Showplace, we've got the Hyatt Place Detroit Novi. And if you're downtown Detroit at the Jazz Festival, there are all kinds of hotels for you to stay at. We've got the Marriott at the Renaissance Center, the Courtyard by Marriott, the Crown Plaza, Hilton Garden Inn, Weston Book Cadillac. There are all kinds of rooms for you to make a weekend getaway and have fun listening to that jazz. So, like we said, all these Labor Day weekend events are the unofficial end of summer, but that means it's time to start ushering in the fall, which means it's cider mill time. So we've got you covered with all kinds of apple orchards to satisfy that fall cider craving, like Parmenter's Cider Mill in Northville. We've got Irwin Orchards in South Lyon with tons of fun activities for kids. There's the Plymouth Orchards and Cider Mill in Plymouth. There's the Franklin Cider Mill with delicious donuts there in Bloomfield Hills. We've got Rochester that has 3. They've got the Paint Creek Cider Mill, Rochester Cider Mill, the Goodison Cider Mill, and then they've got Yates Cider Mill in Rochester Hills. There's Middleton Farm Cider Mill in Utica, Blake's Orchard and Cider Mill in Armada, and then of course there's the huge Westview Orchards and Adventure Farm in Washington Township, and these are just a few cider mills to help you satisfy that fall cider craving. Of course, along with cider mill time comes the fall colors, and we've got 13 metro parks plus the scenic Heinz Drive to cruise to soak in all those stunning fall colors. And along the way, you might just find that perfect pumpkin for Halloween and even get in a hayride or two. And in the D, the fall is still the perfect time to get in some fishing. Lake St. Clair, it's one of the best fishing lakes in the country. There are plenty of charter fishing excursions you can take out on Lake St. Clair. And take it from me, the size of the fish you can catch are immense.
Good, good. Let's pay attention to that screen and make sure we concentrate on this area here. Okay, keep coming.
Uh-huh.
Keep coming. All right. There's your first muskie.
I did it! Wow, look at the size of him. He's huge.
That's not even a big one.
Oh my goodness.
Here
my first muskie ever out on Lake St. Clair. Did not take long, thanks to the expertise of Joel here. And we've even got Labor Day parades going on in Detroit and Hamtramck. Romeo has the Michigan Peach Festival, and the Michigan Renaissance Festival is happening weekends in Holly through early October. So, Labor Day weekend and the fall are a do not miss in the D. Well, that's our show. Thanks for watching. I'm Veronica Vance. And remember, if you would like more information on any of the places we visited, log on to visitdetroit.com. So until I see you next time, go out and explore on your own and discover the D.
To learn about discounts and special offers for featured attractions, plus how to get copies of Visit Detroit magazine, click on visitdetroit.com.
Production funding for this program was made possible by the Detroit Metro Convention and Visitors Bureau, driving tourism growth in Metro Detroit since 1896. More information is available at visitdetroit.com.
Hang on, I gotta figure out how to turn it. Always something happening here. You never know what, hang on. Oh, how's that? Is that better? Keep watching it, thank you.
Did that happen often?
No,
not usually. What I want to do, even to get more direct.